yeah. I got a feeling.
Be 21 here to drink alcohol, so we just go to loads of people's house parties and drink their parents' alcohol.
Topshop, Zara, Ralph Lauren, Juicy Couture.
We tend to on Friday, Saturday, because Friday is a religious day.
I got a feeling. Welcome to my life.
I used to live in England. I grew up there for the first 5 years. Then I moved to Holland and lived there for 6 years. I then spent 2 years in Dubai, which was my favourite. I've lived here for about a year and a half now, and I quite like it. It's quite like Dubai, but there's just less here.
I think Doha is a good place to live for a couple of years, like a good stopover place, because it's sunny and there's kind of few things to do. There's not many buildings around. It's just kind of depressing. You can't really go out here to bars and stuff because they're really strict.
I've lived in Doha for all my life, 17 years. In all honesty, Doha's not such a bad place. I mean, it's home. Fair enough, you don't have all the luxuries, you don't have a lot to do. But as long as you meet the right people and the right friends, you know, you can't ask for anything better here.
It's 6:45 and it's a Sunday morning and I'm just getting ready for a whole week of school. Yes. I've got 2 hours of sport after school today, so I won't actually get home until about 3:45.
I'm stuck in traffic and this is the Doha radio.
Traffic in Doha is really bad and the lights take forever.
See those yellow buildings over there? We live there and it takes us 20 minutes to get to school.
The school's really nice here. It's really nice actually. You get to meet a lot of different kids as well. Asians, Arabic kids, English, Scottish, Irish kids. It's really nice because everyone just mixes with everybody.
This is my school, it's called Doha College.
Welcome to my crew. This is a time of boringness, and Facebook. Sometimes work, occasionally, but not often.
You're right.
great teachers, shit facilities, complicated students.
I absolutely love performing, so I love drama. Miss Evans is a really nice teacher.
Okay, Leela is confident, friendly, got really, really strong directorial skills, talks a lot.
Yeah, she's really easygoing.
She's a really, really strong student, great candidate for teaching for drama.
I love P, so she's one of my favourite teachers.
Leela is very friendly, she's very polite, a nice person to have in the classroom. She's intelligent, she's a great Year 11 student and a great role model to Year 11.
My history teacher's called Miss Rogers.
Hello. She's rude, she's obnoxious. Do you know what? She threw a paper aeroplane at me the other day.
We have kind of a funny relationship. She likes to pick on people and I seem to be her favourite.
And I'm not happy with her.
It's quite tidy. The maid comes in once a day and makes the bed and changes all my clothes around that I leave on the floor. These are all my clothes. I have tons of summer dresses, but as it's a Muslim country, we all have to cover up our shoulders and our legs because of their religion. I used to live in a freestanding house with my own pool and massive garden, but I guess this is okay. Quite nice because I've got a few friends that live around the corner. As you can see, that's my awesome parents. In the Middle East, everyone has maids and they cook and they clean for us and they help us around the house. This is Lena. She's been with us for a year. My dad works for Shell. He's a contracts manager. He works 2 hours away in Ras Laffan. And my mom is a desperate housewife, so she goes to the beach and goes shopping with her friends, and then she goes and has wine at her friends' houses every night.
Don't be a little bitch with your chit-chat.
That's not true.
Let's get straight to it.
A combined science, an E in English, that's got to be an A when you've got a C.
Oh, that's so nice. And he came upstairs and he handed me like 10 roses.